Well, using data from the International Agency for Research on Cancer and their GloboCan database, we've actually compiled data on cancer incidence and mortality around the world with a special emphasis on Africa. We'll be able to show trends, what's rising, what's going down. And actually, this will be very helpful for people who are both interested in cancer for purposes of cancer control planning, or just people who want to know what's happening in terms of cancer around the world. The estimate is that there's about 12.7 million new cases of cancer diagnosed in 2008, and there's a little more than 7 million people who actually died from cancer. We can actually see from the trends that over the next 20 years, the incidence levels are going to double, as are the death rates. We're going to see more cancers in developing countries. As developing countries adapt more westernized habits, including bad diet, lack of exercise, and smoking, we're actually going to see a tremendous increase in the incidence of cancers there. We're actually very interested in what's going to happen in Africa, where there's a very low prevalence of smoking right now, but smoking seems to be growing. There's also tremendous interest in infectious disease-caused cancers. You know, In the developed world, about 1 in 10 cancers is caused by an infectious disease, things like hepatitis B, human papillomavirus, or HIV. In the developing world, it's perhaps 1 in 3 cancers that are actually caused by infectious diseases right now, and that may change over time. Africa is an area where we have a tremendous opportunity to stem an epidemic. It is very clear that over the next 20 years, there's going to be an epidemic of cancer in Africa, and that epidemic is going to be due to the adoption of Western lifestyle habits, especially smoking, but also bad diet, as well as lack of exercise. What we actually have is a tremendous opportunity to stop an epidemic as it's just starting to start. Of the 7.6 million people who died of cancer in the year 2008, 2.6 million actually didn't need to die. You see, we know the cancer control things that need to be done, having to do with tobacco being abolished, changing diet, changing exercise patterns, control of infectious disease. We know all the things that need to be done such that 7,300 people per day who died in 2008 did not need to die. All we really need is to decide that we as a people are going to come together and actually do the things that are necessary to control cancer.